So yesterday was a nice hot day out, and so I started buttoning up this siding, closing it up underneath the undercarriage, running a bead of silicone to seal it up, and then just screwing it into the rail that I ran there. I removed the old door here and the windows, caulked everything up. So mostly it's not leaking, but there are still a few leaks. That's kind of the nice thing about rainy days like today, is that I get to see where all the leaks are. So yeah, yesterday I was just buttoning the siding up nice and snug, watertight to the railing there. And today, because it's raining, I'm doing some inside work. Here's my brake line right here. And it was running up through the floor here before. So I'll have to drill a hole down somewhere underneath here so I can connect the brake line back up. Then at the front here, we have our six-way wire connecting in and up. It was running up through the floor down here. So I'll have to drill another hole and run all the wiring down through the front here. Found a pretty decent doorknob on Kijiji for $5. Fit really well, so I got pretty lucky there. So yeah, today I'm mostly working on getting the brake wiring connected back up. So yeah, I don't know, I'm kind of just trying to remember how it was wired before. I got my cold tied into the frame right there. So that'll go back to the battery without having to run an extra wire. Man, the mosquitoes are bad. That's why it's nice to work inside here. I got my screens put up on the windows, so mostly, like, once I get this siding buttoned up, it should be pretty well sealed. Anyways, this is my main brake wiring here. It used to be running inside the floor all the way through the center of the floor, all the way back up to the front here where the brake wiring was coming up through the floor. And here's my main DC wiring lines for, like, the lights. And they were running all to kind of a breaker box right underneath here. So I think I'll do the same thing, just so I can try to get away without rerouting all the wiring. It's kind of a rat's nest right now. But I plan on having my battery bank accessible to the outside here, so I can have a vent and have the gas, any off-gassing, vent to the outside. And so my battery bank will be sitting roughly here, probably. So all the DC wiring for the lighting has to run back to this area. And mostly it already is. And then also I'll have my my inverter in this area as well, so that I, because there is some AC wiring already in here. It's pretty old, but I think it's sound. I don't think it's unsafe to reuse. I think all the insulation on the inside should still be good. Anyways, it's just a matter of kind of planning out where I want my lighting to go. Like, for example, here's my DC lines kind of running to an old light fixture here. and I'll roughly just keep them in the same locations wherever possible, also trying to kind of plan out where I want my switches and lights and everything. So I believe this was an old switch wire running down here into like a switch, but I want that on the other side of the door, I think. So I'll just reroute that over top of the door here and drop it down on the other side. And this is where the AC unit ties into with AC here. So I don't know if I'll have enough battery power to run the AC unit, but I'll wire everything up anyways. And then if I can get my hands on some decent batteries, then I'll have AC as well. But yeah, right now it's just a matter of finding out where all the old wiring, how it was hooked up before, and just kind of rerouting it. So back here, there's two AC outlets right behind the stove where I won't probably need them, so I think I'll reroute at least one of them, probably drop one of them down into the wall here, because what I'm planning is to have my sink, like have a countertop all the way across the back here, and then I'll have my propane stove in this corner of the counter, and have my sink over in this corner, and then have all my plumbing running in this wall here. So I'll have an outside shower and hot and cold water hookups to the outside there, and probably something like a hot and cold water storage on the inside here for like the winter, for when I'm mobile. Anyways, right now it's just kind of fixing little stuff like this, exposed wiring, just sealing everything up nice so it doesn't start a fire in the insulation. This one is gonna have to be tied into the frame just like the other side. And then I'll, once I get my brake line around, then I'll be able to test out the brake system before I close everything up on the inside to make sure everything's working. But yeah, that's about it for now, so yeah, see you later.